Om Tat Sat. My humble prostrations to the all-pervading energy known as Brahman or God, to my worshipful Guruji, Swami Jyotirmayananji Maharaj, to all the sages and saints of this world, and to each of you, divine soul, watching today's satsang. Today we will be studying Sutra number 32 from the Sadhana Pad of the Raja Yoga Sutras of Patanjali Maharaj. So, the sutra is Shauch Santosh तपः स्वाध्याये ईश्वर प्रणिधानानि नियमः. लेट्स रिपीट. शौच संतोष तपः स्वाध्याये ईश्वर प्रणिधानानि नियमः. शौच मीन्स प्यूरिटी, संतोष कंटेंटमेंट, तपः ऑस्टेरिटी, स्वाध्याय स्टडी ऑफ स्क्रिप्चर्स, ईश्वर प्रणाधानानि सरेंडर टू गॉड. नियमः मीन्स एथिकल ऑब्जर्वेंसेज. रिमेंबर वी सेड यम, वी हैव कवर्ड यमस ऑलरेडी. नाउ वी आर इन नियमस और ऑब्जर्वेंसेज. सो दीज आर द एथिकल ऑब्जर्वेंसेज, नियमस ऑफ. सो नियमस आर डूज, थिंग्स वी शुड बी डूइंग. प्योरिटी, कंटेंटमेंट, austerity, study of scriptures, and surrender to God. All these do's, things we should be doing in our daily life, are prescribed by Sage Patanjali. He says, Shauch or purity is not just physical, it's both physical and mental. So our thoughts have to be pure, and our body has also got to be clean and pure. Keeping this body pure and healthy by cleanliness and a pure diet is the practice of external shauch, purity, while keeping the mind free from jealousy, anger, hatred, lust, other negative qualities, then we are practicing internal purity. So, external and internal. Next quality, do's, observances, is santosh. Santosh means contentment. It is keeping the mind free from the desires for the objects of the world and remaining unagitated in all situations. So a man of contentment is not affected by varying conditions in life and therefore performs all his duties well. He is satiated, he is satisfied, he is not running after more and more possessions, so to speak. He's contented. Tapaha is austerity, consists in developing physical and mental endurance in different circumstances presented by daily life. So when we keep a fast, for example, we are doing tapasya. When we are studying for an exam, we are doing tapaha, enduring, in other words. So then comes swa adhyaya, means study of your scriptures, and that is very important. That is the essence of satsanga. So scriptures refer to both the study and also the repetition of your mantra. If you are following this path seriously, you need a competent guru to guide you, so he can then give you an Isht mantra, a mantra of your choice that will start to do miracles in your yogic practice in life. It will build your spiritual practice. So it purifies the mind and elevates one's thoughts to God. That's why both the study of scriptures and practice of your japa mantra are very important. Those of you who do not know about how to do a japamala or the significance of a mantra, you may please see my videos that I already have on this channel, my YouTube channel, and it talks about why we should, how to chant a japamala and the significance of a mantra also to help you. And finally, Ishwar Pranidhana, or surrender to God, consists in developing the attitude that I am an instrument in the divine hands. Leave everything to God. You become an instrument of God. When you have that level of pure thinking, the divine energy will start to use you as his instrument. Every situation and condition is ordained by God for spiritual upliftment, because that is the whole purpose of our human existence. God has created us to know the Creator, because a devotee brings about supreme surrender to God by integrating his entire personality on the basis of increasing divine love. He loves all and he enjoys the spiritual sweetness that leads him to samadhi, and when he gets there, it removes all obstacles from his path. That is the amazing grace that he receives as a reward for his efforts. The last three niyamas, which are tapaha, swadhyaya, and ishwar pranidhana, are called kriya yoga actions, the yoga that purifies the heart. So that is why we have to follow these prescriptions from sage Patanjali, and we have already talked about this kriya yoga in sutra 1 of this chapter, so you may refer to these things. I'm also putting them all in a playlist, so if you ever have to go and revise a particular sutra, it will be easily available for you. So this is the essence of this, and we will be studying sutra number 33 tomorrow. Om Tat Sat.